Good afternoon, and welcome. We are taking this occasion to formally announce the formation of Rockland County Clergy for Social Justice. Rockland Clergy for Social Justice, leaders of Rockland synagogues, churches, mosques, and temples who are united on behalf of children attending East Ramapo Public Schools, to request Governor Cuomo and legislative leaders to take the following action concerning East Ramapo Public Schools. One, to authorize immediate fiscal and administrative oversight of the East Ramapo Central School District concerning expenditures, budgets, and financial and administrative policies. And two, to implement a study to revise the structure, governance, and financing of the East Ramapo Central School District and the school district similar to East Ramapo as well, in order to ensure that public school students have access to basic educational opportunities and resources as stipulated in New York State's Constitution. Again, I just would like to welcome all of you and thank you for coming out. This here meeting is for the press. We wanted to make our statement to the press, and after our speakers have spoken, we will take questions at the end from the press only. So at this time, I would like to introduce our first speaker, Rabbi Adam Baldachin from Montebello Jewish Center.
The upcoming holiday of Passover gives the Jewish people a chance to shine light on the dark parts of our world. Next week, Jews all over the world will recall the Israelite slavery in Egypt, imagining ourselves enslaved by cruel oppression. We take the opportunity to open our eyes and reawaken our sense of justice and imagine the world as it ought to be. For too long now, the children of East Ramapo public schools have suffered immensely from a poor learning environment. Their voices and the voices of their supporters muffled with the heavy weight of injustice at work. We clergy believe that this current system of governance of our public schools is unacceptable. In a world where every child deserves a chance at a bright future, these children are unfortunately being shut off from theirs. As a community rabbi in Ramapo, I am a witness to this broken system of education. And I stand here today with my fellow clergy because of my Jewish values. As the Torah teaches, Lo ta'amod al dam re'echa, do not stand by while your neighbor suffers. It is our religious and moral obligation to protect our neighbors. We must urge our government to create a just and effective school system. Today we stand for justice, for educational standards for our children, for fiscal oversight, and a new system of governance which offers a bright future to all of our children. To bring back the good name of our schools, of our district schools, we stand for opportunity and freedom. Passover is a holiday not only about the Israelites' emergence from slavery into freedom. It is a reminder to us each year to recognize the enslavement of others wherever they may be, and call for their redemption for a better future. May our leaders hear the cries for reform and be courageous in their work to bring justice to our district. It's now my pleasure to welcome up Pastor Joel Michel, French-speaking Baptist Church of Spring Valley.
Bring you greetings from the members of my congregation at the French-speaking Baptist Church of Spring Valley. This church of about 850 members has been in existence since 1975. It is predominantly made of people of Haitian descent. I am Joel Michel, the senior pastor of the said congregation. Out of a sense of urgency and necessity, I am privileged to stand with fellow clergy on this special occasion to show unity, strength, and commitment on behalf of students attending East Ramapo Public School. The students have been deprived of the opportunity to be part of the race to the top that President Barack Obama has spoken of so passionately on July 29, 2010. In this speech, the president stated, and I quote, "Status quo is morally inexcusable. It's economically indefensible, and all of us are going to have to roll up our sleeves to change it." Is a teenage survivor of the 2010 apocalyptic earthquake that nearly destroyed the island of Haiti. She was sent by her family to live with an aunt in Rockland County to complete her high school education at Ramapo High School to prepare for college. Midway through her junior year, something seems to give way, according to the New York Magazine article titled "Them versus Them," by Benjamin Wallace Wells. The school deans who had handled discipline were laid off, and many students started arriving at school very late or skipping it entirely. The security staff was also cut, and so fights became more frequent, and students often stayed shut in the classroom until the halls cleared. Clubs were eliminated, as well as most sports teams, music, and the drama program, until the communal life of the schools disappeared. Another student, Olivia Castor, is quoted in the same article saying, "It's not that we don't care about graduating, it's that the tools for us to graduate have been taken away. We don't have the classes that can give you a chance to compete. All children are precious beings with one chance to grow into wholesome, contributing members to society. For most of us, education is the means toward reaching this goal. We are witnessing a tragedy in process. East Ramapo Public School governance is broken, and we need Governor Cuomo to address this tragedy immediately." Azeem Farooki from the Islamic Center of Rabbi Valley College.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon. I am Azeem Farooki. My name is Azeem Farooki. I am a trustee of the Islamic Center of Rockland, Valley Cottage, New York. Islamic Center of Rockland is the largest mosque in Rockland County. There are three other mosques. It's located on Mountain View Avenue in Valley Cottage. There are perhaps more than 4,000 Muslim families in Rockland County. And the religion Islam, as you probably know, places a tremendous emphasis on education. Acquiring education and helping to educate others is the most important blessing that a Muslim can have. It was 1,435 years ago when Archangel Gabriel came to the Prophet Muhammad, and the first word he asked him to recite was Ikhra, in Arabic meaning learn, recite, read. So you can see the emphasis on that. And in the Quran, Allah says, seek knowledge many times. Today I am standing with my Christian and Jewish brothers and members of the other faiths, of all faiths, to support the cause of providing and maintaining the same standards of education to East Ramapo Public School students that is available to, 9,000 students in Rockland County, accommodating wide range of religious and ethnic diversity here. I live in Rockland County. My children have grown up but I believe that it's the duty of all residents of Rockland County to support the just cause of providing appropriate education to children attending the East Ramapo public school system, regardless of race, religion, and their parents' economic status. Because that's what America is all about.
Amen.
You cannot deny or impede this opportunity to a helpless child.
Sure.
People from all over the world come to America for a better life through better education. This is the basic principle of democracy. That's what makes America great. I am an immigrant. I came here and I had the honor and privilege of attending the best schools. So I cannot say anything about not having allowed this opportunity to come to other children. And children are our future. Look, had it not been education, the factor of education, Barack Obama would not be the president of the United States. And I believe there are children right here in East Ramapo public school systems who may be the next president of the United States. So when you see just injustice being done, you cannot keep quiet. You must speak and take steps justly and peacefully to redress the situation. So enough is enough. It's time for the children attending East Ramapo Public School to be treated fairly and justly as you would like to see any other child in America. Legislative leaders to take immediate action on behalf of these children. We are meeting with Governor Cuomo later on, soon, and asking for a change in governance of East Ramapo public school system and apply the New York State education laws. They must be applied here as well. Thank you. I request my colleague, Rabbi Hart.
Hello. It's a tremendous honor to be here, these brave brothers and sisters, the brave parents of this district. My name is Ari Hart. I'm an Orthodox rabbi. I'm a founder of an organization called Uri Litzedek, which means awaken to justice, and I'm a rabbi in the Bronx. I'm here with three simple messages, one for the governor, one for the school board, and one for the children. To the governor, Governor Cuomo, listen closely. Listen closely to the parents and children who have been struggling to secure a good education for their children. Teachers and principals and students, they are giving it their all every day in the face of fewer and fewer resources, more and more cuts, larger and larger class sizes. Governor Cuomo, listen to these assembled clergy, these grassroots local voices of moral courage who are calling on you to take action. And Governor Cuomo, listen closely to the voices of hundreds of Jews who I am representing today. In the past 72 hours, over 500 Jewish leaders, rabbis, and community members across the denominational spectrum, Orthodox, Conservative, Reform, have signed a petition in support of this very group and these very efforts. Governor Cuomo, these 500 people who have signed this petition, they're not just from Rockland County. These are your constituents from Brooklyn to Manhattan to the Bronx to Westchester. And guess what? We're bringing those voices all the way up to Albany. Respond. You just did it in Yonkers, and you could do it here. It's time for you to step in and support the children of this county. My message to my Jewish brothers and sisters. Hillel the Elder famously taught, Im ein ani li, mi li. V'im ani rak la'atzmi, ma ani. V'im lo achshav, ematai. The first part of the teaching, Im ein ani li, mi li, says, if I'm not for myself, who will be for me? My brothers and sisters on the school board, Every individual and every community must look after their own needs. There's nothing wrong with advancing one's interests in the political realm. And as a day school alumni myself, and a few years meets Hashem, a day school parent myself, I'm keenly aware of the difficulty in paying tuition for private schools. Your community, this community, has rights, needs, and concerns, and those concerns must be heard. The second part of the teaching, though, says, Ve'im ani rak la'atzmi ma'ani. If I'm only for myself, what am I? When exerting political power, especially of a school board, the needs and concerns of one community must not steamroll the needs and concerns of another. Especially to those most vulnerable within our midst. And the final piece of the teaching, the Imlo Achshav Eimatai, says, and if not now, when? Now is the time. It's time to affirm these values as Rockland County, as citizens of New York, as Jews of New York. It's time to affirm our commitments to being a blessing, the Jewish people, to being a blessing for the entire world, being guardians of righteousness and justice, Shomrei Derech Hashem Lasot Tzedakah Mishpat, and sanctifying God's name through our actions in the public realm. Mm-hmm. Finally, a message for the children of Rockland County, the beautiful children, whether in public or in private schools, whether in Fleetwood or in Vishnitz yeshivas, to all the children, the Talmud teaches that the breath of school children makes the world stand. Amen. Children, your breath is so holy. I see some children here today. Your breath is so holy. Your studies are so holy. Don't be discouraged. Keep studying, keep learning, and know that so many people, these people, there are so many people rooting for you, fighting for you, thousands of people who support your cause. Don't give up, and know that we will be with you, fighting for the best education we can possibly give you every step of the way. Thank you.
Before I would get started, first I would like the Rockland County Clergy for Social Justice would like to extend our gratitude and thanks to the people of First Baptist Church and the pastor, Reverend Weldon McWilliams Jr., for allowing us to hold this press conference here. We sincerely appreciate it. Today what you have witnessed is a group of clergy and church leaders who have come together in an effort to ensure that justice in the form of a fair and decent education takes place in East Ramapo Central School District. We believe that all of God's children deserve education for their minds, and that it is our duty and religious responsibility to stand up and fight on behalf of almost 9,000 public school students of East Ramapo. Perhaps there is no more time more apropos than this Easter season, this resurrection season, where we all should be reminded of the responsibility of carrying the cross. Burdens that oftentimes we must bear, and sometimes we must bear when fighting for and on behalf of those who are exploited and oppressed. The biblical question, am I my brother's keeper? We have come this afternoon because we've answered that question with a resounding yes. We are our brother's keeper, we are our sister's keeper, and we are our children's keeper. We represent numerous congregations in which hundreds of families are represented within those congregations, in which many cases those congregations have urged for clergy to get more involved in this fight for a fair and decent education for the students of East Ramapo. And as it has been reiterated several times before, Rockland County Clergy for Social Justice is calling for two things. The immediate fiscal and administrative oversight of the East Ramapo Central School District. And two, we seek a change in the structure, governance, and financing of East Ramapo District and similar school districts to ensure that public school students have access to basic educational opportunities and resources as stipulated in New York State's Constitution. Yay! also come here this afternoon to say that this is just our first step. That in this fight to achieve this outcome, we have decided and we have committed to travel to Albany on April 30th. And when we travel to Albany, we are asking for an opportunity to meet with the governor, and we plan on meeting with several legislators, hopefully, to bring our proposed solutions into fruition. God bless. At this time, I would just like to bring up one of the people who works with the clergy of social justice, one of the people who we as clergymen lean on and listen to as far as to give us a proper perspective and a historical analysis of the situation going on here in East Ramapo. I'd like to welcome Dr. Oscar Cohen to the microphone.
Good afternoon. At this time, we are prepared to field questions from the press, remembering that this press conference is about how to best approach the governor and legislative leaders to listen to and address the issues of the children attending public schools in East Ramapo. So we'd like the questions to be focused on that particular purpose.
Gian Volpe for the Rockland County Times. I'm curious what the communications with the governor have been like so far.
The question, should I repeat the question?
Yes.
From the Rockland County Times, what have been the communications that have occurred between our group and the governor at this time? The NAACP, I'm the chairman, the education chairman of the Spring Valley in the NIAC NAACP. To date, the NAACP has contacted the governor about this issue and have had a number of meetings with the governor's deputy secretary for civil rights and the deputy secretary for education. And in fact, tomorrow morning, we have our regular conference call, which we have about every 6 to 8 weeks, with these two individuals. The Deputy Secretary for Civil Rights is Alfonso David, and the Deputy Secretary for Education is Ian Rosenblum. We have talked about this situation, about the needs of the public school children. Initially, they said we empathize, we understand, but the governor does not have the power to do anything about the situation. It's only up to the legislature. Over a period of about the last four to five meetings, when we raised with these deputy secretaries that the governor seemed to find the power to deal with gun control and marriage equality and medical marijuana, that we didn't understand that he didn't have any power to deal with the education of children going to public schools in East Ramapo. They no longer throw that back to us. We are constantly asking for face-to-face with the governor, we meaning the clergy for social justice, and we'll be making that same request tomorrow morning when we talk to them. So they are aware of the issue, as is Chancellor Tisch, as is Commissioner King, as is Speaker Silver, and as is the leader of the Senate, Dean Skelos, and Jeffrey Klein.
Thank you. Josh Eating Cases from the Forward. I wonder if any of the clergy people have specific ideas about what the structural reforms that you're referring to in the call would look like, structural changes to how the districts would work.
I know you're asking the clergy, but I'll just say we have talked about this a number of times. We don't know that there is a model. Well, take that back. We know that there is a model, but a model that will likely not happen in this county. One model is a county-wide school system. They do have such a system in Montgomery County in Maryland. They have one in Fairfax County in Virginia, Charlotte, Mecklenburg, and South Carolina. it's very unlikely that this county will ever opt for a countywide school system. I don't think we need to go into the reasons why. Well, one of the reasons why is 90% of the children attending East Ramapo Public School are children of color.
Excuse me, can you repeat the question for us?
I'm sorry. Have the clergy discussed what possible solutions there may be in order to present to the governor and to legislative leaders? So, in response to that question, it really is developing a model that may not exist in New York State, may not exist in the United States, but it is hard to believe that people with the minds of the governor and legislative leaders will say there is no solution. So we'll live with the outcome. And the outcome you heard from our clergy today, the outcome is the destruction of a generation of children in East Ramapo Public Schools. And that's not acceptable, that is not tolerable, and that is what I've learned from working with this wonderful group of people.
And one other thing that I want to mention, Dr. Cohen, the governor doesn't have the power. That's what they say, he doesn't have the power. I think he has the power, but he doesn't have the will.
Amen.
I have a college education and I can't remember. What efforts have been made to meet with and talk to the school administration and or the school board? For the past 2.5 years, the NAACP has made several attempts to sit down with the school board to talk about the tensions in the community and to talk about the conflict between the public and the non-public school system. We've even approached them with a mediator, a pro bono mediator, who is a former Israeli paratrooper, who is a law professor at Hofstra University with a specialty in dispute resolution. It's called ADR, Alternative Dispute Resolution, who sat down with both sides, and those meetings ended because the school board and members from the leadership members from non-school board community of ultra-Orthodox have essentially said, we're not interested in talking with you, we have the power. And if we talk to you, we'll only have to give up some power. So it was not without making attempts to talk and mediate the tensions in the community, which were palpable 3 years ago and which are a lot more palpable today.
I also just want to make this point that you see a formation of a group like this today because the different attempts that were made to have conversations or to establish dialogue, because those attempts were denied, because there weren't productive conversations, because we couldn't get everyone at the table, this is one of the main reasons why a group like this has to be formulated, to continue to put pressure and say you still have a group of people dissatisfied with the structure and the functionings of East Ramapo School District. So there has been attempts historically throughout different groups who have tried to have dialogue and see if this matter can be dealt with in a way in which both all parties could benefit. But because those things have not come into fruition, This is the reason why you see a group like Rockland Clergy for Social Justice forming, because we're tired of having or fighting for just to have dialogue, and we're ready to move further in action and get the governor involved.
Yes, sir.
Yes, my name is Pastor Matt Potterbin from Grace Point Gospel Fellowship, and I'm just going to add a little bit of response here, not directly related to the Rockland County Clergy for Social Justice, but representative of many of us standing here. There have been attempts and some success in saying, can we come alongside this school district? Can we come and serve the children, serve the school district in some way where funds have been cut and so forth? There's a lot of logistical and political things that come with that. If you want to paint something, then the unions don't want you to do that. If you want to, you know, come clean something up, again, the unions and so forth. We have been able to work with a nonprofit organization and provide volunteer tutors in one of the elementary schools. And so volunteers from the congregation have been able to volunteer regularly to tutor with children. Some of the doors may be opening up a little bit for us to take that approach too. But one of the things that just has really stuck with me from the beginning of being part of these discussions is we're not going to discontinue trying to do that. But if we can get 14 volunteers to tutor 14 kids, let's say, that's 14 out of 9,000. Yeah. And the problem is much greater than that. The problem is a governance issue. The problem is an issue that there are over 9,000 kids that aren't receiving what they're constitutionally guaranteed. And so the main focus of this group is to say, hey, it's gotta be dealt with. The state has to come in and acknowledge what's going on and help us figure out how those kids get what they're constitutionally guaranteed.
You know, we're adamant that this is not going to turn into a gripe session, because it easily could. Just me alone. The NAACP did reach out to the administration a year ago when we saw these problems occurring and said, could you just give us, not the names, because they're confidential, give us a sense of which high school students are in difficulty of graduating, and we will see if we could put together a mentoring program to help those students. And the letter was not answered. So again, I apologize for griping. Any more questions from the press? Press?
If there aren't any other questions from the press, we will open it up for about 10 minutes. Any other questions that those in the audience might have for Rockland County Clergy for Social Justice?